Analysing and commenting on graphical output using OSEM. Often, in a statistical inquiry, we need to analyse graphical output. It can be difficult to know what to say. When examining graphs, we look at four main things: position, spread, shape, and special. Within each of these, the OSEM acronym can help. OSEM stands for O, obvious; S, specify; E, evidence; and M, meaning. We will now illustrate this process with an example. This is a dot plot box plot combination for the number of shoes owned by male and female students. You can find out more about this investigation in our video, The Statistical Inquiry Cycle. Each dot in the dot plot represents the number of pairs of shoes one person says they own. The box plot shows the range, the lower quartile, median, and upper quartile for the sample. Our investigative question is the median number of pairs of shoes owned by women greater than the median number of pairs of shoes owned by men? Note that even though our question is specifically about the median, we are also interested in other differences between the two groups. First, we will look at position. As we are comparing two graphs, we need to comment on their relative positions, sometimes called shift. Obvious. We state what we can see. It does not need to be tricky and can be quite obvious. We can see that the graph for the women is clearly to the right of the one for the men. Specify. We say more carefully what we have observed. We say it so someone else would understand what we mean. We could say, the median for the women is greater than the median for the men. In this case, the lower quartile for the women is greater than the upper quartile for the men. Evidence. Here we need to give values to support our observation. We may need to draw on summary values if they are difficult to read off the graph. We could say, the median value for the women is 12, which is 7 higher than the median for the men, which is 5. Or we could say, the lower quartile for the women is 10, which is higher than the upper quartile for the men, which is only 7. Meaning. This is where we link the evidence from the graph with the context or story behind the data and the investigative question. What does our finding tell us about the problem? We can also say why this is relevant and what else we could find out. We could say, this shows that in the sample the median number of pairs of shoes owned by women is 7 more than the median number of shoes owned by men. Our original idea was that women do own more shoes than men, and the data in this sample does seem to support this. We have now gone through the OSEM process looking at position or shift. Note that as we are comparing two graphs, it is important to state specifically the differences and similarities between them. There may be more than one element to comment on for each aspect, but we will not cover everything here or the video will be too long. Now we will use OSEM to analyse and report on the spread of the data in the two groups. Obvious. The spread is much more for the women in the sample. Specify. The width of the box plot for the women is much greater than for the men. Evidence. The interquartile range for the women is 10, going from 10 to 20, and the interquartile range for the men is 3, going from 4 to 7. Meaning. There is more difference in the number of shoes different women have than for men. The central half of the men own between 4 and 7 pairs, whereas the central half of the women in the sample own between 10 and 20 pairs. This is interesting that there is much more variety in shoe ownership among women. In advertising, you would not want to treat all women as the same with regard to shoe ownership. It might be interesting to see if there are other factors that affect the number of pairs that women own. Next, we move on to shape. Do the shapes of the distributions differ, and how? Obvious. The males are in a tight clump, fairly evenly spread, whereas the females are more stripy. Our obvious statement does not have to be well framed. It's good to get the idea down first before developing it further. Specify. The values for the males are nearly uniformly distributed, whereas the values for the women occur mainly in three values. Evidence. We add in the numbers to say, the values for the males are nearly uniformly distributed between 2 and 10, whereas the values for the women occur mainly in three values, 10, 15, and 20. Now we give the meaning. The number of pairs of shoes owned by men is pretty evenly spread between 2 and 10 pairs. Most women stated they own 10, 15, or 20 pairs of shoes. This is likely to be because they had to remember about how many shoes they owned rather than count them. It would be interesting to ask people to estimate how many pairs and then go and count them and see what the difference is. And finally, we comment on any special aspects of the graph. We have already commented on the three spikes in the female graph and given a meaning for it. Special aspects can include gaps, clusters, a tail or skew, spikes, or unusual observations. Sometimes there are no special features for a graph. Obvious. Both the male and female graph have some unusual observations to the right. Note that some people might call this a tail or skew to the right. As there are only a few observations, particularly for the males, I think these are more unusual observations than skew. Specify and evidence. For the females, there are unusual observations at 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, and 60. For the males, there are unusual observations at 33 and 40. Meaning, there are a few men and a few more women who have an unusually high number of shoes. This may reflect their wardrobe, but could also be an exaggeration or a mistake. It would be interesting to check with people who say they own lots of shoes to find out what kind of shoes they are and why they have so many. OSEM is a useful acronym for many forms of analysis. It was invented by Jeremy Brocklehurst, a maths teacher at Lincoln High School, New Zealand. This video was brought to you by Statistics Learning Centre. Visit our website for more resources to help you learn, and subscribe to this channel to find out about new videos.